Hi, this is Josh with another episode of Solar Tech TV. And today we're going to be looking at our MS4448 Magnum PAE Power Center with a Midnight Classic 150 charge controller installed. By the end of this video, you should have your power center breakers turned on and have all the programming dialed in for charge time and voltage. Let's take a look. Before we jump into the programming, there's a couple of things I want to go over as far as expectations. I'm assuming here that you've got all your wiring correct and that you've double-checked all your terminations. Be thinking polarity here. If you've got all your wiring in place, then come on and let's take a look over here. We're going to get our Midnight Classic charge controller turned on first by turning on this right-hand CC number 1 MPPT output breaker. That's going to turn on our Midnight Classic. You should hear the fan blow. It will run through its boot up screen, and then ultimately it's going to require a little bit of programming. For our purposes here, we're going to assume a Crown CR430 flooded battery bank of 8L16s for 48 volts. And we're going to assume a generator of 7 kilowatts at 240 volts. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to get into the main menu of the Midnight Classic by pressing Main Menu, and the first menu item that comes up here is the Charge menu. We'll just press the Enter button between the four arrows to get into the Charge menu, and then the first thing that comes up in the menu there is Volts, and that's where we want to be, so we'll hit Enter again. Once we get in here, we'll see the default values in here for Equalize, Absorb, and Float voltage set points. This is solar we're talking about here, and we're going to need to adjust these numbers up. The manufacturers default these numbers to be very low, and in most cases, they're going to need to be turned up, the charging voltage and the charging time. So I happen to know that the Crown CR430s want to absorb charge at 58.0, they want to equalize at 62.0, and they want to float at 54.0, which are kind of easy, convenient numbers to work with. So we'll get in here and adjust these values up and down here. We'll turn our EQ up from the default to 62. And then we'll use the right arrow to toggle over to absorb and turn it up to 58.0. And we're gonna turn our float to 54.0. Now on the Midnight Classic, the thing to keep in mind is that after you've entered these values in, you've gotta get in and press this enter button and your controller will flash data sent and saved to controller. That's how we know our values are saved in there. Now we've got our voltages in here. Once you verify they're correct with your battery manufacturer, don't use the ones I used if you're not using CR430s. Once you're comfortable with these numbers, we're gonna press the main menu button one time to back out of volts. And we're gonna use the right arrow to go over one click to charge time. This is where our absorb and equalization times are. We'll press enter to get into this menu. And here we have an absorb time of 2 hours. We're assuming an array size of 12 panels that are 60 cells and 260 watts apiece. So with 8 batteries, our absorb time is gonna shake out to be about 3.5 hours. That's what's gonna be required to get us to 100%. This default time of 2 hours isn't gonna get us there. So we have to get in and adjust our absorb time up to 3 hours, 30 minutes. Now, be sure you visit the manual on this. I'm using this based on 8L16 flooded batteries and 12 260 watt panels in 4 strings of 3. You gotta get in and look at the charge time section of the manual for the controller to be sure you're doing it right. Okay, I've got 3 hours and 30 minutes. Here's a pro tip for you. You gotta make sure that your equalization is about 1/2 to 2/3 of what your absorb time is. And you kinda have to tweak it to figure out where it's gonna be perfect, but if we're gonna absorb for 3 hours and 30 minutes, we're gonna start with an equalization time of 2 hours. So we'll get 2 hours programmed in here. And we will hit enter. It'll flash data sent and saved to controller. And that's all we need to do for the Midnight Classic 150 charge controller. It can do a lot, you guys, but the main thing we need to focus on here is charging your batteries at the right voltage for the right amount of time. And that's what we're accomplishing here. Once you've got it saved and you're comfortable with the values that you've got, go ahead and press this status button on the lower left to get you back to the main screen. Okay, now that we have the charge controller programmed to charge at the right voltage and for the right amount of time, we can turn on the input breaker and let power in from the solar array. If you've got sun, your charge controller should start charging batteries. Next, we're going to work on getting the inverter to come on and invert power to AC loads and get some programming taken care of in this guy. So the first thing we're going to want to do with the Magnum inverter is turn on our main DC disconnect here. It's a 175 labeled inverter DC disconnect. We're going to kick this guy on at this point. It should light up our Magnum remote and it should go through its boot procedure and tell you the revision of the firmware you're working with, etc. And eventually it's gonna get to a place where it asks you what time it is. Fair enough, that's my first question when I wake up. We're gonna skip through what time it is to get to a point where we can get in and start inverting power, because realistically, we wanna make sure we can run loads with this guy. Now you'll notice we turn on the breaker and it still says off. We're not off and running yet. We need to get in and press our inverter on off button to actually get the inverter to start inverting. At this point, it'll start inverting, but it's in standby mode because we don't have any of our output breakers on to get AC to our loads. As a result, you'll find this AC output surge suppressor is gonna be blinking in time with this inverter. Tick, 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 tick. That sound is what it does when it's searching. It's a totally normal feature of the Magnum inverter lineup that allows it to save power. When this guy's searching, it only uses about 5 watts an hour. If you disable this feature, it uses about 35 watts an hour. So I suggest you let it tick when you're not running any loads. So, at this point, what you're gonna wanna do is get in and turn on your AC output breaker to let AC power leave your power center and go to your AC load so we can make sure it's gonna come on and run loads. This breaker is labeled inverter AC output, not to be confused with inverter bypass. You'll probably never turn this breaker on. When we turn on inverter AC output, we're gonna send AC power out to our loads and we should be able to get in and see the inverter switch out of searching and into inverting. This blinking blue surge suppressor light on the AC output side is also going to go steady when that happens. And at this point, we've got our charge controller charging batteries and we've got our inverter inverting AC power to loads. Now that we've got our inverter up and running loads, what we're gonna wanna do is program the couple of things that need to be programmed. Again, there's a lot of things that can be programmed and I encourage you to read the manual to find out what it's capable of doing. I'm gonna walk you through programming your battery monitor kit, which is installed in all of our power centers, and that tells you your amp hours gained and removed and gives you a state of charge percentage. It's gotta be accurate or it's not going to give you the correct answer. If you lie to it, it will lie to you. So we're gonna program our battery monitor kit first. And what we'll do is we'll get in here and press setup. We're gonna use the select knob and rotate over to BMK setup and press in on the select knob here. The charge efficiency is set for auto and I recommend you leave it there. But if you go one click clockwise with this select knob, you'll find the default amp hour capacity here is 400 amp hours. Now, if we actually have 430 amp hours, and this thing thinks we have 400 amp hours, it's gonna read 100% when we're really only at 93%, and that's not going to work. To adjust it, we're gonna press in on the select knob and rotate up to 430 amp hours in our case, where we're using Crown CR430s as our example. Now that we have it set for 430 amp hours, and the efficiency is set for auto, we're done programming the BMK. The Magnum doesn't require you to save the settings. All we need to do is now exit out of this menu by pressing the meter button to take us back to the main screen. With our BMK programmed properly and reading correctly, we can then move on to charging our battery bank with an AC input source like grid or generator. As I mentioned for our example, we're gonna use a 7,000 watt 120-240 AC generator for the AC input to our power center. We need to tell the Magnum remote how big our AC input source is in amps so it knows how much it can pull. And we also need to get in and tell it the battery voltage we want to charge at and also the amount of time, just like for solar, but getting in there with those same kind of values for charging up from our AC source. When we get in and we're looking at how to program the AC input amps on this thing, we need to consider the max continuous wattage output on our source. If we're saying it's a 7,000 watt 12240 generator, if 7,000 watts is your continuous wattage output, divided by 240 volts is 29 and change amps. So we know the default in here is 30 amps. If you leave it there, it's gonna pull a little too hard. You'll hear it in the generator when it's running. So what we'll do is we'll get in with that information. Again, if you have a different size generator, we'll divide the continuous wattage by the AC voltage, and that'll give us an idea on where we need to set our AC input amps. We're gonna press setup, and we're gonna rotate this select knob to charger setup. And the first thing that comes up here is AC input amps, and we see it set for 30. What we're gonna do in this case, per our example, is take and drop our AC input amps down to 28 amps. Now we're gonna be able to pull the right amount of AC power from the generator and not overload it. A couple other things we need to verify now. We need to be charging at the right voltage, and we need to be charging for the right amount of time. This is also gonna be in the charger setup menu, so we will continue over to battery type. This is the next thing we're going to adjust here. In our case, the CR430s are a flooded battery, and they match the flooded profile, which is the default battery type in the Magnum remote. Get into the manual there because there are several types, AGM1, AGM2, flooded, and custom, if this isn't gonna work for you. For our example, flooded is going to work. After battery type, we get into our absorb done time. Here we're gonna need to adjust some things as well. We're gonna make the same calculation with our AC generator as we did from solar to get in and say, well, if we have a 7,000 watt generator and our charger can put 3,850 watts into the battery bank and we have 430 amp hours, our absorb time is gonna be right around 3 hours. Again, pick through your manual. The Magnum manual's got a lot of information on absorb time. Be sure you visit that. We're gonna get in and adjust our absorb time up from 2 hours to 3 hours based on our available charging capacity. And that should be about it. At this point, we know that our AC generator is gonna be charging the battery bank at the right voltage and for the right amount of time as well. Okay, now that we've got our Magnum AC input parameters programmed, the next thing we wanna do is get in and turn the generator on. So for the sake of time, I'm just gonna walk you through what will happen here. You're gonna turn your generator on. AC power is gonna come in here. It's not gonna be inside the inverter yet. We have to turn on our AC input breaker. So we turn on our AC input breaker. If the unit sees the voltage coming in, your charge light's gonna start blinking green. And it's gonna do that for about 10 or 15 seconds. And then it should go solid. What it's doing there is qualifying the power. Hey, I see AC power here. Should I let it in? Well, what's the voltage? Well, what's the frequency? Once it's qualified and this charge light goes solid, your display should move from saying inverting to charging and tell you how many amps it's putting into the battery bank. You'll also notice that your AC input surge suppressor should be lit up from the AC input being live. Okay, great work everyone. At this point, our charge controller should be turned on, our inverter should be turned on and inverting, and we will have all the programming in for charging voltages and times, as well as BMK programming and our AC input amperage for the Magnum. If you've got any questions or concerns, feel free to give us a call. This is Josh, the Tech Guy. Have a great day.